Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. To kick off the video, there is some news of SpaceX partnering with Indian companies to produce satellite parts. This article says, in what could prove to be a big win for the government's Make in India push, Elon Musk-led SpaceX is planning to join hands with Indian companies to locally manufacture satellite communications equipment, including antenna systems and user terminal devices. Garrett Riesman posted a tweet saying, affordable reusability has become a critical component of spaceflight. The shuttle was largely reusable, but the cost of maintenance between flights was very high. In some cases, it would have been cheaper to make new parts for each launch. Musk responded with, took more work to make Falcon 9 booster reuse cost-effective than went into recovering it in the first place. This is an important point. Things finally clicked into place with Block 5. My hat is off to everyone at SpaceX, NASA, Space Force, FAA and suppliers who helped make it happen. Musk was then asked, what was the most expensive part of reuse? Was getting the fairings back in one piece the key component? He responded and said, booster is more than half cost of mission, fairing is approximately 10%. Moving on to Boca Chica, ground support equipment work continues at the orbital launch site tank farm. The extension pieces were added to the integration tower stacking crane and it lifted its boom for more tower stacking. Here's a view of the cryo tank shell production. The next cryo tank shell has been rolled out to the launch site. Also, the 8th and final vehicle integration tower segment continues. There was a tweet posted about an article saying Elon Musk shares SpaceX's Starship Raptor production plans to colonize Mars by 2050. Musk responded with, final decision made earlier this week on booster engine count. Will be 33 at approximately 230 or half million pounds sea level thrust. All engines on booster are same apart from deleting gimbal and thrust vector actuators for outer 20. This barrel section, possibly for ship 20, was seen with loads of heat shield tiles. This nose cone, possibly for ship 20, also was stacked onto a barrel section. Last episode we saw one Raptor installed underneath B3, but two were actually delivered. There was only one installed though, as the other was taken back to the production site. Crews were seen continuing to work on B3 prior to the cryogenic proof testing. Then, on Monday, Booster 3 was the first Super Heavy booster to perform a cryogenic proof test. After cryo testing, two additional Raptors were installed underneath Booster 3. Mary posted a tweet earlier today with some very exciting news with a picture of an alert from Cameron County. When these are issued, it is often a sign that SpaceX are targeting a static fire. However, since that tweet, the testing will no longer be happening today. Once again, taking a look at the road and beach closures, we know that Monday was utilized for cryo-proof testing. There was also a date for yesterday that was cancelled. As well as that, there was also a closure for today for the first Super Heavy static fire, but that was cancelled. There is still an intermittent road closure for today though, for something to be rolled out. Then, there is another road and beach closure for tomorrow, Thursday 15th, with the same static fire windows as Mary's alert. So, we could see the first Super Heavy static fire as soon as tomorrow. Finally for this video, I want to share the latest Starbase production diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis, as he has posted a new, updated diagram. As always, I have to say thanks to Mary, known as Boca Chica Girl, who is out in Boca Chica all the time filming. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.